Hi everyone and welcome back. So now we are writing the unit integration test, E2E test cases for the users, and we have written couple of these, right? So what we are doing is we are just overriding this auth service middleware, right? And then we are writing HTTP GET, PUT, POST, whatever the endpoints you have defined. And once that is done, you can simply run npm run cover. So it will actually do all these things, but make sure that you should run the migration for the test database. So when you run npm run cover, it is running the npm run cover unit, cover integrations, and it is also collecting the coverage report out of it. So this is the overall integration of your unit test cases, integration test cases. Okay, now we will also cover some of the unhappy test cases, unhappy path, because I have covered only happy path, like creating the users, getting the users, getting user by ID. But what if you're not providing the authorization token? Then you should get forbidden, right? Unauthorized. And if you're not passing the correct payload in the creating the user, then you should get a bad request 400. If you're not passing the correct ID, or if you're passing this as an empty or some numeric, non-numeric character, then you should get a bad request. All these things you can run from these test cases. We can validate all these things through these test cases. So first of all, you need to run npm run test. That will actually run all the test cases. But before that, it also runs the migration against test database. So if we just see this, how it is working, currently it is running the end-to-end test cases. And if you see the package.json, it has all these things combined. When you do npm run cover, it is running the unit test cases, integration test cases, and finally it is generating the coverage report also. So it is like end-to-end solution for writing the test cases, writing the integration test cases, and then getting the coverage from it. So it will take time, the integration test cases, because it is going to the APIs and it is testing each and every endpoint. So now it is passed, and then finally it will generate the coverage LCOV report, and then it will also post the coverage summary on the console. So we are good here, right? But you can also track down all the unhappy path. Okay, how we will do this unhappy path? You can create a separate file, or let's say if I'm doing spec.ts, and here we can think about covering the unhappy path. Let's say if I'm not passing email, then it should give me 400. So here we can say unhappy path. Okay, here also we are doing get users. So if you are not passing the token, it should give me 401. Similarly, get user by ID, if you're not passing the token, then it should give you the 401, right? And another thing you can say is you can return the validate false from here, right? Validate false means all the methods are going to return unauthorized in this particular case, because your middleware is returning false, and you should get an error, forbidden, which is 403, I think, which we have written in the middleware, because when you, because we are mocking the validate. If it is returning false, then you will get unauthorized. Unauthorized is a 401 status code you are going to get. Okay, so this is how you can write the end-to-end test cases and all. So I will just show npm run test also. So we have written these 400. And we will just try to see this, how it is working. Both are unhappy path. So npm run test, what this command actually does, it actually does, so first of all, you have to run npm run test once you are done with the unit test cases, because it also runs the migration against the test database. So we have the tables populated in the test database, and then we can actually hit the APIs, okay, because it is going to run npm run unit test cases and npm run E2E test cases. Okay, so once the unit test cases are done, it is going to run the integration test cases, and it is also going to populate the coverage for us, and we can also see the coverage report Here in the alcove report, you will see in the index.html. That will give you the overview. Then you can actually look into this and you can see what all files are not covered, what all methods are not covered, and you can write the proper test cases for them. Okay, so this is a summary about end-to-end test cases, how to write, how to cover the happy path scenario, unhappy path scenario, how to mock a particular service method using override provider or using just by defining the providers here, provider array here, and then use value, all these things you can do. Okay, thanks everyone. So this is all about the testing, unit testing, integration testing, and finding out the coverage of your APIs. Okay, if your test case is failing, you should always write fail first and then you fix your test cases.